I don't know whether you all know it today.
Well,
but we're living in that day that the Bible's talking about right now. The subject says, "Oh Zion, what's the matter now?"
Amen.
But if you can open your eyes and look at the news every day, you see there's a whole lot going on.
Yes, sir.
And it's not of that of the Lord, but it's that of the enemy.
Amen.
The prince of this world who come to destroy and try to diminish the works of God. But I come to tell you that nobody can stop the promises of God.
Amen.
Nobody can stop the hand of God.
Amen.
Nobody can stop the work of God.
Amen.
So, O Zion, what is the matter now?
Yes, sir. Amen.
There's a lot that's the matter.
Yes.
People going to church day by day.
Well, come on.
But yet, they don't see the need to receive salvation.
All right. All right.
Hallelujah.
Yes, sir.
Souls are dying in the street cause of drugs.
Amen.
Somebody smoked a little bit too much marijuana and drove down the street that caused an accident. Somebody needed the Lord in the part of drinking alcohol. And because they drank a little bit too much, they lost their license. Hallelujah. But we need to see that the necessity of receiving the power of the Holy Ghost is what we need today. So what's the matter? There's a lot to matter. Our families are breaking up and children are going astray because the mother and the father don't go to church as they should go.
All right.
They send the children to the church and hallelujah, praise God, they sit back at home.
All right.
Don't you know that it takes a good follower to be a good leader?
Oh, yes.
So your children to receive the word of God, but where do you stand?
All right.
Hallelujah. My God. Thank you, Jesus.
Jesus, praise God.
Paul told Timothy,
preach the word.
Preach it in season and out of season. Don't worry about how they look at you. Don't worry about what they say, Mr. Bonnie. No, don't worry about that. But remember, God created the Bible, say, in the days of thy youth. And when you get old, the Lord God will allow you to get a little bit more strong. I feel my help now. The Lord will provide for you. Yes, he will. Lord, I thank you. Just a few days ago, you might see that I'm wearing a different shoe on my feet because I had surgery 2 weeks ago on that feet. But I feel all right right now. God is a good God. Yes, he is. I'm so glad that they that wait on the Lord, the Bible said they shall renew their strength. Can I get a witness? Wait on it. Wait till you change. And just 2 or 3 days ago, we lost our pastor. He passed away. But let me tell you one thing. He passed away, but the Holy Ghost is still here. Can I get a witness? Jesus is on the main line. I can tell you what I want. Can I get a witness? Yes. Oh, Zion, what's the matter now? Can I get a witness? I found out that one day when I found King Jesus, everything began to fall in place. Yes. I learned that Jesus will bring you out of the sin, and shame, and set your feet on straight feet. Can I get a witness? Yes, he will. Hallelujah. Can I get a witness? Hallelujah. When the Lord, Edmonds, tell you to preach his word, stand on the promises of God. God's promise is sure. God's foundation is sure. God's word is sure. Can I get a witness? The Lord, the Bible says, is not slack concerning his promises. As some men count slackness, but he's long-suffering to us all, not willing that no man perish, but every man, the Bible said, come unto repentance. How many know God had no pleasure in a man? Glory to God, that ain't living right. If you die in sin, hallelujah, you're going to go before God on the day of judgment. Can I get a witness? That while we still got breath in our bodies to live right. Live right. If you live right, heaven belongs to you. Can I get a witness? Jesus, in the mighty name of God, I can see him as he hung there from the sixth hour to the ninth hour. Can I get a witness? Well, the Bible said, he laid his head in the locks of his shoulder. Good God Almighty. And he said, it is finished. Can I get a witness? It's finished. All the things I've been through. When they stuck the crowns up on my head. When they pierced me in the side. Good God Almighty. Can they beat me? And so be the word. I want you to hold on. Hold on to the bloodstained banner. Can I get a witness? Sometimes when you're holding on to the bloodstained banner, you criticize. People talk about you. They lie on you. Yeah. Yes, they do. But I come to tell you that on the other side, there's joy. There's love. There's peace, long suffering. Can I get a witness? Jesus is on the main. Tell him, tell the Lord what you want. Good God Almighty, if you want you a husband, tell the Lord about it. If you want you a wife, tell God about it. If you want you a home, and I won't be one. I'm waiting on God. Marvin Williams. Oh, yes. Jesus is trying to guide us down the right road. I heard somebody say, I'm on the right road now. Everything's going to be all right. Good God Almighty. I thank God for the true word. I thank God for Luke 66. Jesus, there's a lot of roots, but they don't lead to the roots. The 66 books of the Bible. The Bible is God's guideline. Can I get a witness? The Bible is God's roadmap. Yes, it is. I'm so glad that I learned how to lean and depend on Jesus, because I found out that if I trust him, that he will provide in the time of trouble. Good God Almighty, the Lord will make a way. He'll be a provision for you. And I get a witness. He's a rock in the wind. He's bread when I get hungry. Water when I'm thirsty. Yes, he is. And not only that, but he's a deliverer. And I get a witness. I had to pray. My wife had to bring me a ice pack, put it out of my head. But you know what? I took that anointing off. And I tell you what, that anointing off makes a difference. God is a good God. Yes, he is. The anointing. The Bible tells us, grace and yoke. Can I get a witness? Glory to God. Oh, Zion. What's the matter now? Listen, when things are going wrong, when things ain't right, all we got to do is look to Zion, look out to the hills from which cometh our help. The Bible says, our help coming from the Lord. Can I get a witness? Just remember where your help is. Your help ain't in your husband. Your help ain't in your wife. One day they're gonna leave you, and then you gotta know that you know that you know who God is. Jesus. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, God. Hallelujah. God's trying to get our attention. He's trying to get our attention. And let us know where our real help is. Your real help coming from the Lord. Hallelujah. People are let you down. They'll tell you, I'll be to your 4 o'clock service.
That's
all right. On the program.
Yeah, that's all right.
Come on.
Well, 4 o'clock come, 5 o'clock come, there ain't nowhere to be seen.
That's all right.
But God ain't like that. When God hears his word, he stands up. I was talking in Sunday school this morning. Come me and my wife go for Sunday school teacher.
Amen.
And I said to the men in the Sunday school class,
yeah,
I said, you know, a man that give you his word,
well,
yeah,
and don't stand on his word,
well,
isn't much of a man.
Well, that's right.
Amen. Can I get a witness?
Because
a real man gonna do what he say he gonna do.
Amen.
Amen. We might have pitfall, we may have mistakes in our, but we gonna come up to the stature and the fullness of Christ.
That's right.
To where the Lord wants to be.
Amen.
We're not defeated.
That's right.
Sometimes it look like we're not making progress.
All right.
But just remember, the Lord didn't lift you up to let you down.
No, he didn't.
A song like I say, if I had to reach way down,
Jesus
will pick me up.
Amen.
How many know when you get down sometimes like that, people step on you? I see some don't want you to go down. So they can take the spot.
Yeah.
But Jesus won't leave you down there bouncing. Huh? When you get down and it look like you can't see up, the Lord knows all about it.
Yeah.
Can I get a witness?
Yeah.
Yeah. son in his promise. If he said, I'm going to deliver you, I'm going to deliver you. If he said, I'm going to save you, I'm going to save you. If he's going to bring you out of that situation, he's going to bring you out.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Come on.
Praise the Lord.
Praise
the
Lord.
Yes, man, Elder Evans been going through some of the same situations lately here. God bless him. Get his truck back.
Amen. Yeah.
Yes, sir. While he was going through these changes, my past God praise him. Amen. But the good thing about it, God blessed me with another one.
Amen.
Amen. That I've been had since April, and I thank him for that.
Amen.
Because if it wasn't for that, I might have been in trouble right now. I see the wood, I see all the other stuff, but Father, where's the lamb? Abraham said, don't worry about the son. God gonna prepare one.
Amen.
You look over the thicket over there. There was a lamb. Amen. Hallelujah. That wasn't there when they first got up there, put the wood on the altar, amen, and began to make what God told him to do.
Yes, sir.
See, don't see when God tell you to do something.
Uh-huh.
Don't you know he's gonna make the way?
Amen.
What God tell you to do?
Yes.
Amen.
Huh?
Right.
He gonna do it.
Oh, yes, he will.
Yes, he will.
Yes,
God said, go there. Go there. Go there. Me and my wife was at the hospital when we left y'all.
Amen.
We prayed for the sister of our church, sister of the world. But I passed by a man door. And the Lord said, pray. And I just stopped right in the hall where I was, took my wife in, and I prayed for that man.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know why God said pray for him.
Right.
And see, you know what people don't understand? I ain't got to come back up on the box and put my hand on to pray for him.
Right.
Prayer reaches down to the lower valley.
Right. Right.
It goes to the highest mountain.
Right.
It goes in between every crack.
That's right.
It ain't no distance of prayer.
That's right.
No direction.
Yes.
Prayer moves
yes.
by the power of God.
Yes.
Amen. I'm done.
Amen.
I ain't no long-winded preacher.
I said what I got to say tonight.
Amen.
Get up and sit down. Oh, come, what's the matter now? Went on the Lord's side.
All right.
There ain't nothing to matter.
There you go.
Because you give all your problems. There's a songwriter say, take your burden to Jesus. Your burden, he'll bear.
Amen.
Tell him your trouble, and your trouble, he'll share.
Amen.
He's waiting just to bless you with an outstretched hand.
Amen.
Tell him your trouble. Your trouble here, I'm the same.
Oh, yeah.
That was Bishop F.C. Barnes. He used to be my pastor, too. I know many of y'all know the rough side of the mountain. He's the pastor that used to sing that. He used to be my pastor in North Carolina.
Amen.
Powerful man of God. He's deceased now, but amen. He was a preaching and singing man. He was an artist, singing artist.
Mm-hmm.
And I tell you what, that man had a family that could really sing, all of them that I do could sing. Brothers and sisters and stuff, too. Amen. So, and he lived what he preached. That's what we got to realize saying. You know what? And Elder Edmund said something when he was up here testifying. We are living in a day and time where if you was playing with God, ever playing with God, you better get on the right track.
Right.
Playing time is out.
Yeah.
Look around you.
Right.
Can't you see what's going on in society? Anytime somebody want to legalize two men marriage, something wrong with you.
Amen.
God did not put Adam and Steve together.
Amen.
No
prayer.
No prayer.
Amen.
Amen.
It's a shame before God.
Amen.
It's an abomination in the eyes of God.
Amen.
God ain't pleased with
you.
The foundation of marriage was ordained by man and woman.
Amen.
Adam and Eve.
Amen.
And anytime you go astray from the ordinance and the commandments of God and take things in your own possession and do what you want to do, you're in trouble with an awesome God. That's going to judge you for those deeds that you've done. And I'm going to tell you right now, no lesbian and the homosexual is going to be in heaven.
Come on.
I got to tell it like this. I'm a preacher, and I believe in God's word just like it is. So if anybody can accept God's word, there's something wrong somewhere.
Amen.
And you might not realize, but amen, God is going to stand behind his word 100%.
Amen.
And we better stand on the promise of God. We better stand firm on the word of God. We may not have more power than our Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God's trying to get this world's attention. That we need a change. They looking to the president.
Oh yeah.
Don't you know the president can't fix this world?
Oh, man.
Amen.
He's the first man. But if he or she don't have God in their life, how can you be a good leader? A real leader.
Amen.
I seen stickers on the back of a car say that real men love God. Stuff like that. I serve God. Now I have to go along with that. Because a true servant of God is going to love God. It's going to follow God's ordinance, God's plan, God's commandments, God's word. And they're not to say that those other men are not men, but they're not men of what? God.
Right.
There's a difference between men of God and just ordinary men.
Right.
Amen. Right.
But true followers of God are going to follow the word of God. And now is the time to get right with God and do it, as the Bible says now. I don't want to be left down here twiddling my thumb like people say, Lord, come and playing games, Lord.
Yeah.
And not being what I preach, as that old saying, practicing what I preach.
Right. Amen.
But a true leader gonna lead his people right.
Right.
So that they can make it to heaven. And that's why I thank God for my pastor. He may pass on, but the word and the teaching he taught me and my wife and all the other members, we'll never forget him.
Amen.
And not only that, but the love of God, he showed us.
Yeah.
He showed us.
Yes, he did. That's right.
And I stood up on the night of Friday night when we all of the ministers, they let every minister speak on behalf of their pastor. He passed on Thursday night.
Uh-huh.
And I had to say, I said a few things, but one of the main things I said was that my pastor was a true man of God. And out of all the other pastors and leadership that I've been around, and I've been on a few other pastors in North Carolina, that my pastor I had, Bishop James Tank, was the best pastor I ever had.
Man.
Because he lived what he said he was.
Right.
He showed love, he showed kindness,
he
helped the poor, he helped the needy.
Yeah.
He done exactly what the Bible said that a true man of God is supposed to do. And that's how you know a real true child of God.
Man.
They don't show that real agape love.
Man.
Real love.
Real love.
See, love is spoken, but you have to live by the things you say to be a real man or woman of God.
Amen.
And I'm done. Hallelujah. Old time, what's the matter now?
All right.
The only thing I can say that's the matter now is that we need to get on the right track.
All right.
And follow the program.